Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Welcome to Liverpool Cathedral for this Eucharist at Christmastide, and a very happy Christmas to you all from all of us here at the Cathedral. We're delighted that you should be worshipping with us during this Christmas weekend. We pray together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Christ, the light of the world, has come to dispel the darkness of our hearts. In his light, let us examine ourselves and confess our sins. Lord of grace and truth, we confess our unworthiness to stand in your presence as your children. The Virgin Mary accepted your call to be the mother of Jesus. Forgive our disobedience to your will. Your Son, our Saviour, was born in poverty in a manger. Forgive our greed and rejection of your ways. The shepherds left their flocks to go to Bethlehem. Forgive our self-interest and lack of vision. The wise men followed the star to find Jesus the King. Forgive our reluctance to seek him. From all your sins, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Oh,
Let us pray in the peace of this Christmas celebration that our joy in the birth of Christ will last forever. Lord Jesus Christ, your birth at Bethlehem draws us to kneel in wonder at heaven touching earth. Accept our heartfelt praise as we worship you, our Saviour and our eternal God. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Angels from the realms of glory, bring your flight o'er the earth. Ye who sang creation's story, now proclaim Messiah's birth. Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favours." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
May I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Many of you know that at the start of lockdown in March, I set myself the task of walking 8,000 steps before the working day began. I still do this despite the darkness and the weather. Over the past few weeks, my thoughts have been fueled by darkness, and as dawn breaks, by the glimpses of light. The darkness and the glimpses of light remind me of COVID-19 and the past 10 months, as we as a country have struggled to get to grips with the pandemic. The darkness of COVID has seen people suffer from the loss of loved ones, the loss of jobs or businesses, and the loss of a direction in life. The glimpses of light have been seen in people like Sir Captain Tom, all frontline workers, and Marcus Rashford. Darkness and light play a central role in our Christian story, as we think of the dark world that Jesus was born into and the dark world of his death. Alongside the darkness of the world Jesus was born into, we see the hope that Jesus brings as he feeds the poor, speaks out for those on the margins, and welcomes the stranger. Our readings today speak of darkness and light. The prophet Isaiah speaks of the people who walked in darkness, seeing a great light. He speaks of the joy that will be felt at the end of the battle, which will destroy the enemy. The future is good as Israel looks towards a new heir, a son, a king. The new king will be wise in dispensing justice. Wonderful counselor. He will have the power, skill, and strength of a God, mighty God. He will be as reassuring and protective as a great tribal leader, everlasting father, and will be a bringer of peace and prosperity, Prince of Peace. The king will bring light and life through his rule of justice and mercy toward the weak and poor. The new rule the king brings is not of self-glorifying power, but a power of love and justice for others. Luke's gospel also speaks of this king who will rule through the power of love and justice. Light floods Luke's Christmas story as the angels bring their message of good tidings to a humble young woman and to those shepherds who are on the margins of society. Shepherds are outcasts at the time of Jesus. They lived with their sheep on the hillsides. They were the lower class of Jesus' world. But it was to these poor shepherds that the angels appeared in all their glory with beaming light. They were offered good news of great joy, good news for them and for all people. They were told that a new king, a Messiah, had been born in the city of David. This new baby, they are informed, will be given the throne of his father David. At this time of Jesus' birth, the world was moving according to the orders of Caesar Augustus. But although he was hailed as the great bringer of peace, real peace on earth would come only through the authority of the child born in Bethlehem. This Christmas story is the story of the birth of a new kind of king. The birth reveals a new order, not under Caesar, but under God's direction and rule for the redemption of all peoples. In this world, God's word is heard not by the rich and powerful, but by the humble, the poor, and those on the margins. There is a place even for shepherds. There is hope in this Christmas story for the oppressed, and those who heard what God is doing were filled with joy God has not forgotten us or abandoned us to the brokenness we have created. The story of Christmas is both an announcement of hope and a call to humility. If we have ears to listen and are humble in heart, we too are offered that good news of great joy. We are offered hope, hope of a world free of injustice, a world where the hungry are fed, where the sad are comforted, where the sick are healed. The light of Christ's birth offers us a different world, and so this Christmas, amongst all the darkness, let us rejoice and hear again the story of our Saviour's birth. Let us see the glimpses of light as we live as hopeful people, knowing that whatever darkness we feel, Christ is walking with us, offering glimpses of hope. The people who have walked in darkness have seen a great light. May I, on behalf of the cathedral staff and chapter, wish you a hope-filled Christmas. Amen.
Let us declare our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray to our incarnate Lord, who has brought us out of darkness into his own marvellous light. Christ born for us, Son of God given for us, help us to know you, to worship and to serve you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Wonderful Counsellor, you order all things with your wisdom. Help the Church to reveal the mystery of your love and to fill her with the Spirit of truth. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Mighty God, the government is on your shoulders. Guide the leaders of the nations and bring your kingdom of justice and righteousness. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Everlasting Father, you call us to live together in unity. Protect by your mercy all your children. Bless our families and renew our communities. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Prince of Peace, you bring reconciliation through the cross. By your healing power, give to all who suffer your gift of wholeness and peace. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Hear again the song of the angels. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to all in whom he delights. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Word made flesh, life of the world, in your incarnation you embraced our poverty. By your Spirit may we share your riches. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts, we lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. All glory and honour be yours, almighty, always and everywhere. Mighty Creator, ever-living God, we give you thanks and praise for your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, who for love of our fallen race humbled himself, was born of the Virgin Mary by the power of your Spirit, and lived as one of us. In this mystery of the Word made flesh, you have caused his light to shine in our hearts, to give knowledge of your glory in the face of Jesus Christ. In him we see our God made visible, and so are caught up in the love of the God we cannot see. Therefore, with all the angels of heaven, we lift our voices to proclaim the glory of your name and sing our joyful Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, Joseph, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Rejoicing in the presence of God here among us, let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break the bread of life, and that life is the light of the world. God here among us, light in the midst of us, bring us to life and light. Jesus is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Heavenly Father, as we participate with your people in these holy mysteries, we pray you now to grant to those who seek your gift of spiritual communion, with trust in your faithfulness and your abiding love. Amen. The body of Christ broken for us, the blood of Christ shed for us. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God our Father, whose word has come among us in the Holy Child of Bethlehem, may the light of faith illuminate our hearts and shine in our words and deeds, through him who is Christ the Lord. Blessed are you, Sovereign Lord, King of Peace. To you be praise and glory forever. The new light of your incarnate word gives gladness in our sorrow and a presence in our isolation. Fill our lives with your light until they overflow with gladness and praise. Blessed be God. May the Father, who has loved the Eternal Son from before the foundation of the world, shed that love upon you, his children. May Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one things earthly and heavenly, fill you with joy and peace. May the Holy Spirit, by whose overshadowing Mary became the God-bearer, give you grace to carry the good news of Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, come down upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.
Good morning, and Christmas blessings to you all as we look forward to the new year. We hope you enjoyed our online service. One of the challenges of this type of service is the opportunity for you, the worshipper, to offer your gift at the altar through the offertory. The offertory or collection gives us the chance to say thank you to God for all that God has given us. The cathedral last year lost over £35,000 of income from its collections. If you wish to show your gratitude to God and God's Church, you can do so by going to the cathedral website and following the donation button. If you wish to prepare at home for worship, then please do go to the Preparing the Sunday Gospel material on prayerforliverpool.org.